Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum students, I hope so you all are fine. Welcome to e-learning class again. Today we will start computer memory. Our topic of discussion today is RAM and ROM. We have already discussed internal processor memory, and today we will discuss RAM and ROM. RAM stands for random access memory. It is the fastest memory that is installed on the motherboard. RAM is a read-write memory, means that we can read and write into the random access memory. It stores all the active programs and data, means all the programs that are being processed are stored into the RAM. Plays an important role in processing speed. The size of RAM affects the processing speed. The more the RAM, the more will be the processing speed of the computer. It is a volatile memory, mean the data stored onto the RAM is removed when we turn off the power of the computer or electricity is shut down. When we turn on the computer, in this diagram you can see that when we turn on the computer, at that time RAM is empty. Nothing is stored into the RAM. All the operating systems, all the application software, all the programs residing on the hard disk and are waiting to be loaded to the RAM. In this diagram, you can see that when we turn on the computer, BIOS actually is a program. A personal computer uses to get computer started after when we turn on the computer. It is also manages the data flow between the computer operating system and all the attached devices like keyboard, mouse, printer, etc. Actually, this BIOS will take this one operating system from the hard disk and load it into the memory RAM. When this loading is done, that we are able to see the main desktop of the computer. At that time, computer is ready for the further operations, for the further processing. In this diagram of motherboard, you can see that these are the memory slots. On these memory slots, RAM chips are inserted. The greater the size of the RAM, the greater will be the processing power of the computer. Here is the ROM. This is the ROM. There are two types of RAM: static RAM and dynamic RAM. Dynamic RAM consists of millions of memory cells. Each memory cell is an electronic switch. As we know that electronic switch has two states: state on, that represent the one, and the state off, that represent the zero. Memory cells are made up of transistors and the capacitors. In this diagram, you can see that these are the memory cells holding the information 0 or 1. One memory cell can hold one bit at a time. That may be a 0 or that may be a 1. A computer supplies a small amount of electricity power to these cells. The electricity leaks out from these cells. As soon as the electricity leaks out from these cells cannot hold the further information. The information that is stored in these cells is deleted, as you can see in these diagrams. Many computer needs to recharge these cells many times per second. So recharging or powering these cells is compulsory. If these cells are charged, they can hold the data. Computer must recharge all cells in the memory chip many times per second, as I have told you. This memory chip, dynamic RAM, can be used as a temporary memory. Number two, static RAM. Static RAM is also organized in the same way as the dynamic RAM, consists of many memory cells, and each cell has an electronic switch. And each, as I already have told you, each electronic switch has two states, on representing one and the off representing zero. static RAM works in different way that there is no need to recharge the cells in this static RAM. All the cells holding the information remains, this information remains stored into these cells until we turn off the power of the computer. There is no need to recharge these cells. But it requires more transistors. This static RAM is more faster than the dynamic RAM. This static RAM is more expensive than the dynamic RAM. And this static RAM is used as a cache memory in the computers. Number two, read-only memory. Read-only memory, R for read, O for only, M for memory. Read-only memory, the process of entering the information into the ROM is called the programming. Here you can see I have written the point programming the ROM. In some ROMs, the data programmed cannot be changed, but on the other hand, in some ROMs, data can be erased and that can be reprogrammed. ROM are used to store the programs that are frequently required and are not changed during the operations of the computer. All ROMs are non-volatile. Non-volatile means that the data stored on the ROM retain on the ROM when we turn off the power of the computer. There are three types of ROM: PROM, EPROM, EEPROM. PROM. P stands for program, R for read, O for only, M for memory. Programmable read-only memory, or we can say that programmable ROM. A ROM is a semiconductor chip. It is available by the manufacturers in an unprogrammed state. Means user can purchase and reprogram it. Means that user can purchase it and write the data into this ROM according to his requirements. But one disadvantage of this ROM is that we can only program it once. We cannot program it again. We cannot write data in this ROM again and again. ROM is used in electronic switches that require some information to be stored permanently. Number two, EEPROM. E stands for erasable, P stands for programmable, and ROM stands for read-only memory. In other words, we can say that erasable programmable ROM. This type ROM have contents that can be reprogrammed, that can be reprogrammed by using some ultraviolet light, using some specially circuitry, but note the main point that outside the computer, we can reprogram these ROMs outside the computer using ultraviolet light and using special circuitry. This procedure can be carried out many times, but constant reprogramming makes the chip useless. Means that we can erase the data many times, we can write the data many times in this ROM, but this makes the chip useless. EEPROMs are generally used for programs designed for repeated use, such as BIOS. Number three is EEPROM. E for electrically, E for erasable, P for programmable, and ROM for read-only memory. In other words, we can say that electrically erasable programmable ROM. It also being used for ROM applications. This EEPROM can work like a read-write semiconductor memory while retaining the non-volatile nature of ROM and PROMs. This EEPROM works in similar way to the flash drive. It is used to store a computer system's BIOS and can be updated without removing it from the circuit board. Means that no need to remove the BIOS for the reprogramming of this ROM from the motherboard. We can reprogram this ROM without removing it from the motherboard. There are some questions of your exercise, short question. How the size of RAM affects the processing speed of computer? Note down this answer. The second one, the short question is differentiate between RAM and ROM. The complete answer is written here. Note it down. And some few interesting questions. You find the answers. In which memory operating system is loaded during booting process? On which memory BIOS is stored? Thank you. I hope so. You understood the lecture.